A day of diplomacy in Luxembourg saw the UK Prime Minister come away empty-handed and leave a podium empty as well.
I repeat, this Brexit, it's not my choice.
Prime Minister, who's picking up the bill?
Arriving for his first face-to-face meeting with the EU Commission President Jean-Claude Juncker, Boris Johnson didn't talk up the prospects of a deal with the EU. After a two-hour working lunch, one which Downing Street described as constructive, Johnson made it clear that he wouldn't ask for an extension to Brexit. The EU, for its part, issued a statement insisting that the ball was still in Britain's court.
It's reported that Boris Johnson wanted this meeting to take place in a neutral location, and as such, the tiny Grand Duchy of Luxembourg, sandwiched between France and Germany, the big axis of power in the EU, was chosen. But even here, protesters against a no-deal Brexit made their presence felt.
This is my first demonstration. I've never been in a demonstration. We feel so strongly about this matter and about how our rights are going to be destroyed by Brexit, even with the deal. Even with the withdrawal agreement, our rights of free movement go out the door.
Mr. Johnson, CNN, how confident are you on a deal?
Avoiding questions became a recurring theme for Johnson, with the PM pulling out of what was supposed to be a joint press conference with his counterpart from Luxembourg, who spoke regardless.
Our people need to know what is going to happen to them in 6 weeks' time. You can't hold a future hostage for party political gains.
Addressing reporters later and homeward bound, Johnson reverted to his usual optimism.
Yes, there is a good chance of a deal. Yes, I can see the shape of it. Everybody can see roughly what could be done. But it will require movement, and it will require the system by which the EU can control the UK after we leave, the so-called backstop, to go from that treaty.
Until it does, with 50 days left, Brexit negotiations appear, for now, to be going nowhere. Nina Dos Santos, CNN, Luxembourg.
Or they were asking you, I should say, about how the president asked you to deliver a message to Attorney General Jeff Sessions where he would unrecuse himself and limit the scope of the Mueller investigation. So let's just listen to this for a moment.
That's what he wanted you to deliver to Attorney General Jeff Sessions, correct?
I believe that's an accurate representation.
And he wanted you to deliver it to Jeff so that Jeff could say it to the people, right?
I believe so.
So you confirmed that you were asked to obstruct justice.
No, Allison, please. That's not what I confirmed at all. By the way, the Mueller report was very clear. There was no collusion. There was no obstruction.
That's and not what the Mueller report said, Corey.
It absolutely says that.
And Corey.
You should read the page that states that on. And Bob Mueller
had the opportunity
to testify to that.
Wait a second, Corey. Hold on a second. Time out. Did you read the Mueller report?
No, I never did.
Then how do you know what it says?
Because the members of Congress were very clear about what was in that report yesterday. And so I'm reiterating
Corey, no,
what they stated.
No, Corey, sorry.
Did
then
you read
wrong.
The report?
Corey, of
Allison,
course I had to read the report.
You read the entire report?
Corey, of course I had to read the entire report. And
okay.
Let me tell you what it said.
Tell me.
There were 10 different examples of obstruction of justice in
That's
there.
That's not what it said. It did not say there were 10 examples of obstruction. Allison, you're being disingenuous.
Corey, here
it
they
said,
are. Let me pull them up on the screen for you since
okay,
you didn't read the Mueller report.
Put the Mueller
so
report up on the screen, please.
Here we go.
That's not the Mueller report,
Here are
report,
the
Allison.
Examples.
Allison,
when the president
the
asked
report.
Comey to let the Flynn investigation go, when he tried to stop Sessions' recusal. That's the one that you were involved in. You may want to read that part. When he fired Comey, when the president tried to remove Mueller, when the president tried to get Sessions to limit the probe, that's another one you were involved in. When he obscured the purpose of the Trump Tower meeting, when he asked Sessions to reverse his recusal, asking McGahn to deny attempts to remove Mueller, trying to influence cooperation of witnesses, including Flynn, Manafort, and Cohen. Those are just some of the examples that scores of legal experts say are obstruction of justice.
How can legal experts make a determination when they're unfamiliar with all the facts of the case? Allison, I didn't think anything was wrong. The president never asked me to commit a crime. He never asked me to do anything
yes,
wrong.
He did, Corey. We
he
have it
not.
Right here. You admitted it yesterday. Why are you not admitting it today?
I admitted that he never asked me to commit a crime yesterday. You're absolutely right. I did do that. I admitted yesterday that the president never asked me to commit a crime. I concur with your decision. Yes, that's
Corey,
accurate.
Asking the Attorney General to limit the scope of an investigation that the president is being investigated for is a crime.
Allison, we're talking about a hypothetical conversation which never transpired.
This isn't hypothetical.
And a meeting which never occurred. And instead, I went on vacation. So you can get all worked up in a tither about a conversation which may or could have potentially occurred, but it never did. I never met
and
with
Jeff. And why didn't you
Maybe you didn't hear me. I took my children on vacation.
Why didn't you meet when you got back from vacation 2 weeks later? Why didn't you meet with them?
Because I don't live in Washington. I wasn't here.
In 2001, when I was a teacher out in Vancouver, I attended an end-of-year gala where the theme was Arabian Nights. And I dressed up in an Aladdin costume and put makeup on. I shouldn't have done that. I should have known better, but I didn't. And I'm really sorry. There are people who've made mistakes in this life, and you make decisions based on what they actually do, what they did, and on a case-by-case basis. I think I deeply regret that that I did that. I should have known better, but I didn't.
And
I
think this is never done.
How do you feel about this coming out right now in the campaign?
Obviously, I regret that I did it. It's not about timing. It's about having done something that I shouldn't have done. And I'm really sorry I did.
Have you done something like this, Mr. Trudeau? Is that the only time in your life you've ever done something like that?
When I was in high school, I dressed up at a talent show and sang Deo with makeup on.